The second repechage in the men's single sculls to come now. We have contestants from Iran, from Niger, from Chinese Taipei, from Lithuania and from Zimbabwe. Representing Iran is Mohsen Shadi Nagadeh, 24 years of age. Alongside him from Niger, Hamadou Chibu Isaka. In lane three, from Chinese Taipei, here is the man in the dark glasses, Wang Ming-Hui. And from Lithuania, Mindautas Griskunis. And finally completing this lineup from Zimbabwe is James Fraser McKenzie. Just 19 years of age, 6 feet 1 inches tall. But can he make it through into the quarterfinals of the men's single sculls? Second opportunity awaits them in the shadow of Windsor Castle. Some spectators still arriving for an excellent view that's afforded from the banking there. All poised, and they just await the final instruction. Final introduction. TPE means Taipei.
Iran, Niger, Chinese Taipei, Lithuania, Zimbabwe, attention.
The word is attention. Pay attention, they get a green light. Niger got a particularly slow start, I'm afraid. Hamadou Chibu Isaka. He's going to struggle to make it after a really slow start. He had a poor day yesterday as well. He came in last, a long way last, and he's already left way behind here. It's Lithuania's Griskonis who is hitting the front in lane four. Looks to be going reasonably well too. He's just edging the second place ahead of the Taipei rower Wang Ming-Hui. Four of these scholars in this race have finished fourth in their respective heats, hence their appearance in today's repechage. The Lithuanian actually was going pretty well throughout most of his race. Griskonis in his going well again here today now. He looks to be in a bit of a different class, to be fair, to the rest. Just look how far behind Hamadou Chibu Isaka is, the man from Niger, who does some of his training in crocodile-infested waters in Africa. So Griskonis for Lithuania. A couple of good Lithuanian rowers in the Olympic Games competition, and he is certainly the one to catch at the moment here. Iran in second, Zimbabwe in third, and Taipei in fourth at the moment. That's things stand, and here comes the representative from Niger. You can see it's very slow progress for him, and about 22 seconds down on the leader. He is a novice to rowing, I think that's only fair to say. Good luck to him to compete in the Olympic Games, take some guts. It's amazing how many countries are represented in this international rowing event, the Olympic Games. The 30th Olympiad. Dalgas Griskonis for Lithuania looks very, very strong here, poised for victory in the second repechage, which will clinch his place in the quarterfinals. The first two, remember, go through. The three rowers who don't make it into the quarterfinals do get an opportunity to so that everybody knows exactly what position they're finishing. stroke rate, and impressive for the moment. He's up to 33. Clear water for the Lithuanian to survey as he can see everybody in the field at the halfway point. He's got a very, very healthy advantage indeed over Charlie Magade, over Fraser McKenzie. You know, the biggest cheer of the day will probably be reserved for the rower from Niger, because he'll come in a long way last, and everybody will stay just pulling over the finishing line. First across that line would appear to be Griscoes, the way things are going at the moment. He doesn't appear to be in any trouble at all. He's capable of holding the advantage he's built for himself. Single Sculls, as you can see. Has a great deal of strength and presence of mind. All about the rhythm. So the first two to go through. Barring some misadventure, it would appear that the first of those two is going to be Griscoes. There could be yet a battle for second between Magade of Iran and Fraser McKenzie from Zimbabwe. The Zimbabwean rower here. There's no great surprise in this, I have to say. Griscoes was expected to be the first across the finishing line in this Repechage event, and he's three quarters of the way home here now. Coming up in 5:13.6. A good 7 second advantage over Shadi Nagade. Fraser McKenzie now moving ahead of Wang. 350 metres to go then for the Lithuanian Griscoes. So there'll be some celebrations this evening in Vilnius. Very good effort from the Iranian Nagadevo. You can see the amount of water between the respective boats. This just shows the respective strengths of the competitors here. And Griscoes has taken a stranglehold on this race right from the word go. And certainly left the Niger competitor a long, long way behind. There's never been any question that he would be the first home. So Griscoes heads for home now. Still Magade leading the chase. Fraser McKenzie and Wang Ming-Hui locked in back at the third place. The course of fourth place. Sometimes here it's just the first two. Clinching his place in the quarterfinals is Griscoes from Lithuania. And he's just established himself as somebody who can make his presence felt in the quarterfinal as well. And the Iranian in second, he too qualifies for the quarterfinal. And the fight for Taipei, for Zimbabwe, and for Niger. There will be no medals at these Olympic Games of 2012, but a delighted Mindaugas Griscoes waves to the crowd, waves to his coach, and he's done his job well today. And listen for the roar, here he comes, take a bow, Hamadou Djibo-Isaka. Who was it who said it's not the winning, it's the taking part that matters. And he's getting a terrific hand. I only took it well 3 months ago. It's a kind of extraordinary to complete in the Olympic Games. And to complete the course. Those are the sort of heartwarming moments that make the Olympic Games what it is. Osaka of Niger getting a bigger hand than the winner of the race. And you shouldn't really be thinking about his time. The encouragement is just keep going. He's nearly there. One more. It's hard work, isn't it? It's one of the golden moments of the game so far, I think that. But the winner of this second repechage, Griskonis of Lithuania,